describe your first bite.
The first thing that happened was I lost my ability to see color, where it was a monochromatic world. It was just shades of yellow from white to black. And I'm looking around and just thinking, this is not good. I hadn't heard of the symptom, but one does not need to be an Oxford Don to realize that no good is going to come out of something like this. Then I got a strange metallic taste, like my mouth is made of living metal, and then just went into this sensory vortex, you know, that's like a bad LSD trip. You know, this is not the fun kind of hallucinations. You know, sounds are distorting, shapes were not quite there. And then I pulled over, told the lady at the counter of a convenience store that I'd been bitten, and then promptly puked all over the entire store, basically.
Why have you survived all of the 20, is it 26?
Well, it was 26 at the time of the writing of the book, but then I was trying some new sea snake gloves last year, and a sea snake that was tangled up in a net got through the gloves, but it had used up all its venom chewing on the net, so that one sort of counts, so I'd technically be 27.
Let's look at the science, though, because the science of venoms is fascinating, and you were looking at some of the therapeutic possibilities of venom. What are some of those possibilities?
Well, a good example is if you know of anybody who takes high blood pressure medication, odds are they're taking a class of compound related to the drug captopril, which is the founding member of this drug class. And that's a modified snake toxin that was done in 1976. It remains today a $10 billion a year market, you know, whose importance cannot be overstated. It's actually been one of the top 20 drugs of all time. But we can only develop those kinds of drugs if the animals are still around. These kinds of venomous creatures need to be looked at as a resource to be preserved. Like when I have my students, you know, they'll ask me, you know, what can we do to get people to understand the value of conservation? I always say, your weakest argument is to talk about how beautiful or wonderful creature X, Y, or Z is. You know, that they are not, no one's going to appreciate this who doesn't already think that way. You're preaching to the choir. If you're trying to convince very right-wing people who want to just chop it all down and put up a parking lot, you have to point to the fact that, you know, of the conservation through commercialization angles, that destroying these forests is no different than exploding a nuclear bomb on an oil field. No, you have destroyed a vast resource that's irreplaceable. So with the snakes or any venomous animal, there's an infinite number of things that can come out of them. We have, even have experimental treatments for dementia using a scorpion peptide, but we can only do those sorts of things if we have the resource available to us.